The car never stopped. It never paused. In the front seat, a Secret Service man was on the telephone. The car picked up speed and disappeared beneath an underpass.
Well, Dan, that's a moment that seared all of us. And I'm wondering, in this age, when the media is so different, when the way we look at the news and the way we receive and report the news is different, how do you think the Kennedy assassination would be covered today?
Well, the coverage would be much more intense. There would be many more people covering it. Mm-hmm. At the time of the Kennedy assassination, there were basically two dominant American television networks.
We started the company with a product that existed before we started the company. It was my totally designed hardware, software built, all my conception, the Apple II computer, was all of Apple's revenues for the first 10 years. You built a company that had millions and millions of dollars to invest in new projects, and every one that Apple tried without me, they all failed.
Pick up the newspaper, turn on the television, listen to the radio. One would think that the world has lost its compass. Not so in this room.
He was ruling Holland and Belgium. At the time of Napoleon, he was banned and he was in England, and he was a witness of the first steps of the Industrial Revolution, using coal to make steam and then to power machines. And that was, for mankind, a real revolution.